Make sure you save money on any of these sales. If you're going to buy digital games, you may as well use code SWITCHUP over at switchup.gg to get yourself a nice chunky little discount, 5% off instantly and 5% back in coins. And your voucher gets delivered by email straight away. All the info's in the description. Hello everyone, welcome back to Switch Up. It's Sunday, it's freezing cold here in the UK, and I need to chop some wood so that I can sit by the fire and play some games. But before we do that, we have to have a look at the sales. Now, there are some absolute crackers this week. There's a load that I've never talked about. We've got a good chunk of Savaloys, and then the Indie Spotlight as well. All right, what are the best games on sale this week? Well, my name is Mark Walker. Welcome back to Switch Up. Join our Discord. There's a link in the description, and we'll be doing our Best Games of the Year awards soon. So yeah, jump on there if you can. For everyone else, well, let's find out. First up, we've got Terraformers, which is 30% off until December the 9th, and I did a video on this the other day. I'll pop a link to that in the description, but the long and the short of it is, it's very, very addictive. I'm a big strategy game fan, and this essentially sees you setting up a colony on Mars, choosing one of their political leaders. Well, I say political, one of them's political. Then there's like a leader that is essentially like a builder. There's one that's really good at mining, and you gradually colonize Mars, but then the terraforming comes in the form of building different machines, spreading bacteria, changing the environment by increasing the amount of oxygen, etc. And then that changes the way the planet looks. I had an absolute blast with this, brilliant game. And I also noted that it's already quite cheap, but at the moment it's 30% off. That's just £12.59. If you're interested, go check out the full video on that because it's really fun. This episode is sponsored by one of my favorite games. It's Honkai Star Rail. This one's like a fully fledged RPG and is a new multiplayer space fantasy RPG from the makers of Genshin Impact known as Hoyaverse. It's now available on PS5 and you can search for it on the PlayStation Store, syncing up your saves from the PC or the mobile versions. I know when we spoke about it last time on the channel, there were a lot of you that were like, yeah, this game's absolutely amazing. And there is a brand new limited time 5-star character known as Huohuo. She's a wind type support character who is on the path of abundance. She can restore her allies' health and can also support her team. The other brand new character is known as Argenti, who it's fair to say is a little more aloof, but is a physical type character on the path of erudition, with massive area of effect attacks, and he looks quality. With the 1.5 update that's just come out, they added in some like ghost busting missions, some new characters, as well as new story elements, and a return of Silver Wolf. It was a popular member from the Stellaran Hunters. If you log in for 7 days, you'll get 10 free Star Rail special passes, 10 free pulls, and you can use all of this to draw Huohuo or Argenti. Make sure to download using our link in the description or the top pinned comment, and use the redemption code below to retrieve your 50 Stellar Jade. And a big thanks to Honkai Star Rail for sponsoring this episode. Then we've got the Portal Companion Collection, which is 66% off. An absolute bargain. It takes both games, Portal 1 and 2, down to just over 4 squid. £4.58 for two games and two really, really good first-person puzzle adventures, I'll call them, because they definitely have an adventure element to them. I wouldn't be put off by the fact that they're clever in the sense that you don't have to worry if you're not clever enough to play them, because they're designed in such a way that it gradually teaches you the mechanics, and that's part of why they're so good. Now, the first game's in here really good. The second, I think, is better because it features the voice, of Stephen Merchant as one of the characters, and I think he's just hilarious, isn't he? For both games, though, absolutely essential at that price, and another that we have a full video on if you want to check that out. From that, we can jump over to Doom Eternal. That's 75% off in all regions, down to £8.74. Now, it's really nice because this one's actually had a lot of patchwork since it first came out. There will be people that say, oh, you absolutely shouldn't play it on Switch, like they do for most Switch games, because it's better elsewhere. I mean, that's just a complete, almost a nonsensical statement. Yes, you can find it better elsewhere, but being able to play it for 4 or 5 hours in handheld, well, that's a bit of a push, let's be honest, it won't be that long. But just being able to play it in handheld on a device like the Switch that doesn't get hot, that doesn't make a ton of sound, yeah, it's worth it. And the actual core gameplay is all in there and it's all intact. There is some DLC as well available for this one if you find yourself blasting through it. And there's a sale on the first Doom game if you haven't played that one. When I say the first one, I mean the Doom 2016 release. This one had a bit more verticality. There was a bit of like platforming and swinging through the air and stuff, which some people liked and others didn't. didn't, but I thought it was great. Now, I'm really, really pleased to finally see some bigger titles get some significant discounts. That brings us to Dragon Quest XI S, one of my favorite games, probably in the last decade. Certainly JRPG, one of my favorite JRPGs of all time. This is 50% off here in the EU regions. So the UK, the EU and Australia, 50% off. And in America, I think it's 30 or 33% off, but I have seen some larger sales on the physical copy. So it's worth checking that out as well. If you are after a pure, and I mean pure RPG, JRPG, with all the mechanics you'd expect, turn-based combat, at least I will say you don't have random encounters here. You can actually just engage enemies as and when you want, although obviously you'll have boss fights that you have to overcome, like that really annoying squid one on the boat. Do you remember that one? That killed me so many times. I think I left the game for 6 months and came back and was like, oh, this isn't even difficult. What was I doing? But yeah, very long as well. You'll get 60 hours in and it will suddenly like start again and you'll be like, what on earth? But it's one of those where you're pleased for it to go on longer because you really do get invested in the characters, even though some of them are a little bit annoying. Like that, what's his name? Is it Silvano or something? I think I've got that wrong, but yeah. Really amazing game, well worth adding to your collection. The sale goes on until December the 3rd. Off the back of that, we've got Live Alive, which is the same discount in the EU and the US region. So you've got 50% off here and 30% off over in America. I'd never played the original before, so it was really nice playing this one on the Switch. And it uses that lovely HD 2D style, which I think Square have actually patented, if you can do such a thing. I'm sure you can. But you play a series of different stories from different eras and times, and they're all really very cool. Now, some of them, I will say, do show their age. Just in the design of them, they can feel a little disjointed. But then there are others, like there's, it's like a martial artist guy, isn't there? That was absolutely brilliant. And then it manages to weave those stories back together, as Square have become experts at doing. But yeah, this is one we did, Glenn and I did a massive review of. Because it's such a big game, we just thought better to be late and just have played it all. So yeah, you can check out, I'll pop a link to that as well in the description if you're interested. But that's $19.99, or your regional equivalent. Now, The Witcher Tales Thronebreaker, I think, is probably one of the best deck builders we've got on Switch that combines that deck building, an RPG, I don't know if you call it a formula, but that combination, it works so well here. I'd never heard of this game. I know it had come out on previous or other platforms, but I was very familiar with Gwent from The Witcher 3, which is essentially the card game that you'll use in this for some of the battles. Now, this has two aspects. You've got the open world map you can move around, but then you've got things like the camp where you can talk to the other people in your party. It's used to facilitate quest lines and things, but I think the game just looks stunning. I absolutely love this style. So if you're after something maybe a bit different to your norm or your usual, then yeah, I would say that's definitely one to consider. The sale for that one is 60% off and it goes on until December the 3rd. I saw a ridiculous comment on the Tales of Iron's Twitter for the developer, the publisher. Someone posted one of the reviews on Steam for this game was, if I wanted to play Dark Souls, I'd have bought Dark Souls. And for me, that doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense at all. Yes, it has a few Souls-like elements, but it also has Metroidvania, like some action gameplay. Some commenters on just online in general, like, I do wonder to myself, like, what are you doing? What are you doing with your life? You're just wasting your time. Tales of Iron is a cracking game. It has the beautiful narrations of Doug Cockle, aka Geralt of Rivia. It's got a lovely art style. And I wouldn't at least have thought that a game featuring a load of mice and rats would have been that enjoyable, but they managed to really pull it off and still make it quite dark as well. It's just £5.49 or your regional equivalent. That's 75% off, and that goes on until December the 3rd. I can't even say Wonder Boy Dragon's Trap, the Dragon's Trap, without hearing my brother's voice, because he sang this one and he recorded a tape cassette back in the 80s to convince my parents to buy the original game. It was so ridiculous. It just was a loop of, I've got to get it, Wonder Boy the Dragon's Trap. And he just played it constantly. It was like, it was like hell. But I've got to be, you know, respect where it's due. You know what he got on Christmas? It's Wonder Boy and the Dragon's Trap, which probably wasn't the message my parents should have delivered to him, because my word, did we hear a lot of songs after that point. Brilliant game though, and I love the work they did to update the visuals. The new visual style here, it for me does justice to the originals, because it's so, so good. And you can switch between the old and the new whenever you want, so no one can complain, you know. The core gameplay, it's a little more dated, I would say. It's quite simplistic, you know, like single hit enemies, things like that. but actually there's mechanics in here that have stood the test of time. Like, you gradually unlock different animals that have different abilities. I think it's like the mouse can walk up the walls and things like that. And that in and of itself made the game kind of ahead of its time when it first came out. But it still also has those end of level rock, paper, scissors battles that you can actually cheat if you know the method. But yeah, really good game. Well worth it for just over £5, 70% off until December the 3rd. Now, I want to mention Tales of Symphonia Remastered, because they have put a lot of work into patching this one. The problem that we've got is it's not based on the 60 frames per second GameCube version, which instantly puts most people off. Well, actually, no, it doesn't put most people off, let's be honest. It puts nerds like me off, but it is a bit weird. Now, this runs on, I think it's the PlayStation version, which ran at 30 FPS, but even then it had a few stutters. Well, it had a lot of stutters. It had some sub 20 frames per second performance areas. They've done a lot of work on patching it. I think it's had about 4 or 5. I've only been able to visit one of them officially, and then I've played the others behind the scenes. But it is in a much better state than it was, and it's one of the best RPGs we've got. So I would recommend, if you're a fan of RPGs and you haven't played this one, forget the remastered moniker. That essentially means it's running at HD widescreen. Other than that, you're not getting anything special, really. But for £21, you're getting a decent chunky RPG that you're going to get a lot of value from, most notably the storyline. The storyline's just great. That sale, like all of these, goes on until December the 3rd. Now, Young Souls was actually reviewed by Asdin on the channel. It's half price at the moment, and I think it's a bit of a hidden gem. It's one of those that a lot of people overlooked just because it came out during a busy time, but it's a great little game. It's centered around two orphans known as Jen and Trista. It's not Trista, is it? It was Tristan. Yeah, Jen and Tristan, that was it. And it plays out like a side-scrolling RPG beat-em-up. The good thing about this, and I think we probably didn't give this quite as much attention as we could have done because it was played by one person, is the fact that it features full co-op, and that co-op mode's brilliant. You customize your characters with different items and gear, and that includes loads of different weapons that changes the way that you play the game slightly, and there are 20 boss fights in here as well. There's also quite a few little mini-games in there. There's one in like where you're in a gym trying to build yourself up and stuff. Yeah, really cool little hidden gem in my opinion. Half price down to £11.24. Check out the review if you're interested. That goes on until December the 3rd. Last but not least, we have A Space for the Unbound. This is 30% off, £12.59, and one of my favorites again, I'd say in my top 10 Switch games. Is it the best game ever? No, probably not. But does it manage to capture a feeling, a mood? It absolutely does. It has this like early 90s feel to it. There's a scene where you go into the arcades and you've got this real douchey character who thinks he's the absolute bomb on the arcade machines. But then in the blink of an eye, you're in a dream world filled with weird cats, and it all gets a bit Donnie Darko. And there's one really memorable scene. I don't think this is a spoiler really, but it just kind of encapsulates that feeling of going to the cinema with someone you fancied for the first time, and like the hands touch and stuff like that, but you're in control of when you reach for the popcorn and stuff like that. Yeah, really, I love this. I thought it was brilliant, and I bought the physical actually, which for me, if you've been around the channel, is not something I usually do. I got it off PlayAsia. We have a link to that and a discount as well in the description if you want to buy some physical stuff before Christmas. But yeah, A Space for the Unbound, lovely little game with some weird Donnie Darko vibes. Now, our Saveloy selection this week, or your Costco hot dogs, or your insert different weird junk foods that only cost a little bit of money. And this is our series that is a load of very cheap games, essentially. It was like £2.99, something like that, but I'm gonna be a bit flexible with that, but these still be very cheap. First up, you've got Torchlight 2. Now, I know someone mentioned they wanted to know when this one went on sale again. It's 80% off at the moment. Has a Diablo feel to it. Features a mount that is a unicorn, I believe, if you're so inclined, and a very good, enjoyable, fast-paced action RPG experience. At 80% off, definitely worth it. A Short Hike has to get a mention because I love it, and I would love for some people to play it before Christmas. When it's getting colder, a cozy game like A Short Hike, which can be completed in a few hours, but features just a little bird and you're gliding around, you're gradually ascending this mountain. Yeah, loved it. Tribes of Midgar is 75% off. I would say this again is a bit more of a hidden gem, and it has just had the massive Valhalla update. But what you're looking at is In its simplest form, an ARPG. But for me, the way this is best played is to join a tribe, in air quotes, online of up to 10 people and play against the computer. You're essentially building up your village and defenses and then fighting off these creatures. And what's cool is if you do play online, is it actually adapts and changes to the amount of players you've got. Finally, for the Savloys, you've got Luca, Born of a Dream, 70% off. A bit of an artistic marvel, this one. It has such an interesting style, but still manages to be fast-paced hack and slash combat that also features ranged combat in there and uses color to essentially facilitate some of that. You can befriend familiars, and there are moves like the slow motion dodge that just look pretty cool. Now, on top of that, you can actually use rewinds to instantly retry a battle, which is nice, because let's be honest, these games can be a bit brutal. So our indie spotlight this week, I'm going to give it to Night Dive Studios. Now, I know it's not a small indie, but these guys have been killing it with their revisits of classic games. And two examples are Quake and Quake 2. Quake is 67% off at the moment, Quake 2 60% off. And these had so many bells and whistles that they weren't simply remasters. They're almost remade in certain ways. New lighting effects, the models completely revamped. So yeah, I would strongly consider checking out some of the work of Night Dive Studios. They've also done the Turok games as well. And we did a review of Turok 3 the other day. Just brilliant, such good work. So much fun to play, and almost the best way of ever playing these games. So that is it. As we say at the start, save yourself some money on any of these. Use our code SWITCHUP over at switchup.gg to buy your eShop credit. You get your code through instantly. You can still get your normal Nintendo coins when you use it. And we get a little kickback from Nintendo, so happy days. Thanks to our Patreons and our members and all of you that enjoy the content. And as always, for all things Switch, all the time, keep it SWITCHUP. Cheers, guys. See ya.